This is an Eyewitness News webcast.
Hi, I'm Kelly Byrne. Here's your Eyewitness News webcast on this Thursday, October 18th. Let's get a check of your forecast with meteorologist Stefano DiPietro.
Good morning, Kelly, and it's going to be a very chilly day today with temperatures that are only going to end up making it into the 40s this afternoon, right around the mid, the upper 40s at best. But the trade-off is we do get some sunshine. But this is well below average for this time of year. And something else you're going to notice today, the air that's with us, very dry. Now, normally we look at dew points in the summer to tell how it's feeling. It feels muggy, sticky, or steamy. But when they get down to the 20s and teens like this, the air is very dry. So that means you'll notice it on your skin, probably in your nose and your sinuses through the day today. 46 for the high in the Eyewitness Weather Forecast. It's windy and chilly, clouds and sunshine. The wind will be at around 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, 32 for the overnight low, 60 tomorrow, so a pretty good Friday. Then we'll get a little rain on Saturday and even a flurry or snow shower on Sunday as the wind picks up and we fall back to the 40s, Kelly.
Well, thanks for that update. And as Stefano just mentioned, some of us are seeing a few flurries today, and it just so happens that PennDOT just released its plan for the upcoming winter. Now, PennDOT Secretary Leslie Richards says the agency budgeted nearly $230 million for this winter's statewide operations. There will be about 4,500 on-the-road workers and 620,000 tons of salt on hand. PennDOT released a recruitment video as the department tries to supplement its full-time staff. Every winter, the agency looks to fill hundreds of temporary positions, including equipment operators, mechanics, and welders. John S. Clark Elementary Center in Pottsville is dealing with mold issues once again. The school closed on Wednesday and will remain closed for the remainder of the week. The building was reportedly tested on Monday, and elevated mold levels were found in certain areas. The school officials say they hope to have students back on Monday. An update will be provided to parents tomorrow. Well, those are today's top headlines. Have a great day.